With the release of Plasma 6.1 a few weeks back, a feature that people had asked about for years. I may have completely forgot to upload this video, ignore that. Actually got added in a convenient and easy to use way, modifier only shortcuts. Now, I talked about them in my 6.1 video and my stream on 6.1, but I feel like they deserve an entire video unto themselves because they are a really cool system, and there's some things about them which may not immediately be obvious. Firstly, when we say modifier only shortcuts, what are we actually referring to? What are your modifier keys? So your modifier keys are those keys you have that modify an existing action on your keyboard. The easiest one to explain is the shift key. When you press the S key, this makes a lowercase s. If you hold down the shift key, this makes a capital S. This isn't the only modifier key. You also have your control, Windows, super, meta key. Those are all the same key. Different systems refer to them differently. I'm just going to say meta key for the rest of the video, and also the alt key. There is also the right variants as well. Right alt, sometimes called alt grave, right control, right shift as well. These are the main ones that matter on Linux. If you have a Mac keyboard, you'll also have a command key, but that doesn't really matter. There is also technically a function key on certain keyboards, but generally this isn't recognized by the operating system and is instead used to modify the actual keyboard actions itself, usually things like changing a lighting mode and things like that. For the sake of this video, the ones that mainly matter are Shift, Control, Meta, and Alt. Now, when we're talking about modifiers in the case of shortcuts, they're generally not used to modify a shortcut. Instead, they are used as a way to have different layers of shortcuts using the same main keys on your keyboard. So something like Meta S is going to be a different hotkey, a different shortcut to Alt S. But when we say modifier only shortcut, the shortcut doesn't have any of those additional keys. It is only the modifier keys being used in the shortcut. So things like Meta Alt, Meta Shift, or the one that you'll commonly use on Plasma, that being just the meta key to open up the application launcher. Now, changing or deleting this key in old versions of Plasma was a little bit annoying and a little bit tedious. It could only be modified by going into your KWinRC and changing this line, or just running this command. Nowadays, though, it is considerably easier and is treated the same way as all of your other shortcuts. So go into your shortcut section, go to here, and if we search for application, go down to Plasma Shell, right here, activate application launcher is just easily modifiable. I'll keep this window away from the edge of the screen so you don't have to see two of my faces. Now, with these modifier only shortcuts, what can we actually use them for? What can we set to have a modifier only shortcut? Every single hotkey that exists in this settings screen, doesn't matter what it is, whether it's opening an application with a custom command, whether it's doing something with Spectacle like printing your screen, whether it's bringing up the emoji selector or doing something in Dolphin, anything that you want to do that you can configure in this screen can now be set to a modifier only shortcut. Now, there's a lot of things you probably wouldn't want to set, but if you want to set something like the window overview, for example, let's set this one to meta. And then let's apply that. We'll zoom out again. Now, if I press the meta key, it opens up the window overview. Maybe instead you are a cube enjoyer and this is how you swap between your workspaces and you want it to just be on a single key. There you go. Or maybe the way you interact with your system isn't something you've dragged over from X11, dragged over from Sway and Hyperland, where everything you do is with this little bar down the bottom here, whether it's opening applications or opening playlists and anything like that. Maybe instead you do it in the Plasma way and you do everything with KRunner, Crunner, whatever you call it, and you want it to be on a single key and you don't have a search key on your keyboard. Set it to your meta key, set it to your alt key, whatever modifier key that you prefer it to be on. Now, there's some very important caveats with the way these modifier-only shortcuts function that differ from the regular shortcuts. So with a regular shortcut, let's say for opening up my application launcher, if I press Super D, it opens up straight away. This is not the way that a modifier only shortcut functions. If I press the meta key to open up my overview, nothing happens. Nothing happens until I let go of the key. So a regular hotkey is run on press, a modifier only one is done on release. This is for good reason, to make sure you don't break every other hotkey on your system. Let's imagine that modifier only shortcuts were also done on press. Well, if you had something bound to the meta key, how would you ever do something that is also bound to meta D or meta W or meta C or anything else? Because the instant you press the meta key, it would instead go and run the thing you have bound to meta. So by putting it on release instead, it gives you a chance to go and run the hotkey you want to run instead. Or if there is not a hotkey you want to use and you actually do want to use the modifier only one, then when you let go, that will be run. Now, because it is on release, it is going to feel slightly delayed, maybe slightly laggy, depending on the operation you're doing. This is just a sheer fact on how the system has to function to make it work with everything else. And to the best of my knowledge, there is not a way to configure whether it's done on release or press, and there probably shouldn't be, because this is one of those settings which would just lead to people thinking that things are broken. The second very important thing is the way the modifiers interact with each other. If you are just using single modifier keys, whether that be meta, whether it be shift, whether it be control or alt, they all work exactly as you would expect. You could even do something like control, meta, and alt, and this is going to work perfectly fine as well. If we go set that, and we press all three of those, works just fine. You can go and press them in different order slowly. You can start with the meta key, press control, and then press alt. It still works just fine. The problem happens when you have the shift and the alt key together. Okay, so let's bind alt and then shift. It looks like it's bound perfectly fine. Okay, let's press alt, shift. It looks good. Let's press it again, which should be a way to get out of the overview. That seems like an issue. Okay, let's escape out of that. Now I'm going to press shift and then alt. Shift and then alt. Nothing is happening in this case. And I think I know partially why. I'm not sure why the first thing happened, but let's bind this instead of by pressing alt and then shift, shift and then alt. Now it shows up as meta plus alt plus shift. The shift key modifies what the alt key is doing, and it registers as a different string of keys. Now, even though this shouldn't be the binding, this actually is what it is set to. If I apply that, press meta, alt, shift, meta, alt, shift, meta, alt, shift, meta, alt, shift. That's working fine. But again, if we press the shift key first, meta, and then alt, shift, meta, alt, shift, meta, alt, doesn't work. This interaction with the shift key doesn't happen with any of the other modifiers. So if I instead do, let's say, meta shift, this one isn't going to cause a problem. This is going to work. Meta shift, meta shift, shift, meta, shift, meta, meta shift, meta shift, shift, meta, shift, meta. That works fine. So it is just a weird interaction of shift and alt. My suggestion, just don't combine them. It's gonna be a headache. It's gonna be a problem. It's gonna feel buggy. Just don't do it. Now, regarding the bindings, make sure you're paying attention to whether one is actually being set. So if I press something with a regular binding, like meta W, that is instantly gonna try to be set. But if I instead do meta alt, it doesn't get set again until you let go of the keys. So if I instead let go of the alt key first and then let go of the meta key, it doesn't actually set anything. So make sure if you're trying to set a modifier only shortcut, you let go of both the keys roughly around the same time. There is a slight window. It doesn't have to be on the exact same frame, but it does have to be pretty close together. Now, early on, I mentioned your right modifier keys, your right shift, right control, and right alt. Now, technically, these are different keys on your keyboard. However, if I press the left shift, this shows up as shift. If I press the right shift, this shows up as shift. If I press the left control, control, right control, control, they will be treated the same. And again, this is not at playing tricks on you, being like, ooh, it says the same thing in the UI, but it's not actually the same thing. If I press left control, it does that. If I press right control, it also does that. They are treated like the same key. Keep in mind that does give you a little bit less flexibility, but in other ways, it does make the binding just a little bit easier to use if, for whatever reason, you want to press the right control key. This also applies to multi-key bindings as well. If I bind this to Control, Meta, Alt, all done on the left-hand side, okay, that's fine. If I then go and press Control, Meta, Alt, left-hand side, overview, works perfectly fine. If I do Meta and then Alt and Control on the right-hand side, also works perfectly fine as well. Is there a case you're going to want to do that? I don't know. Maybe. But just know left and right are the same thing. Now, personally, I don't like having things like my application launcher opening when I press the Meta key. I am too used to the problems on Windows where if you press that key, it would open up your start menu when you're playing a game, and nobody wants to do that. So I just make sure it is always bound to nothing and never have to deal with it. But I'm not opposed to the idea of modifier-only shortcuts. As I mentioned, if you heavily use things like the overview, maybe having it on a single key would be easier to access. If you heavily use things like the cube, maybe on a single key, or Crunner on a single key. Now, also, there are some bindings which exist on other desktops which you couldn't replicate on Plasma before. Now, apparently on Cinnamon, I don't know if it's still there today, but apparently it was there a long time ago, where there was a binding on Meta Control Alt to keep a window always visible on top of all of the other windows. If you're doing something like, researching for a report, and you don't want to keep losing your text editor or word processor, you want it to always be visible above everything else you're doing, having a binding like that is pretty useful, and just having it on that line of three keys does make it pretty easy to remember. Now, personally, I've been trying it out with a different binding. Here we have a keep window on all desktops. I'm going to bind it to Control, Meta, Alt. So now if I want to have this window right here visible on this workspace here or any other workspace I'm using, I just press all three of those keys and now it just follows me everywhere I go. Basically, it just works like a regular set of shortcuts. It works like having this be on Meta S or Meta T or anything else like that, but it's a smaller subset of keys, so depending on what you're doing, might make the binding a lot easier to remember, so you actually end up using it in a more frequent way. The possibilities are absolutely endless with modifier-only shortcuts. Just keep in mind that they don't operate exactly the same as a regular shortcut, so they might feel a little bit different to use. But what do you think? Have you been using modifier-only shortcuts? Do you like having things on a single modifier, or do you prefer having the regular shortcuts where it's on Meta T, it's on Shift Meta S, or whatever other bindings you might like to have, just because it's something you've always been using? But if you want to try out something new, maybe have a play with this new system and just see how it goes. Let me know your thoughts down below. So if you like the video, go like the video. And if you really like the video and you want to become one of these amazing people over here, check out the Patreon, Scribes, Libera Pay linked in the description down below. That's going to be it for me. And what do you say? Windows, Meta, or Super? I'd like to know as well.
something. What is this?